The AFL and Richmond both released statements this morning. So the nightclub investigation came to its close and the AFL won. The AFL had its way. Shea Bolton conceded at length that he exacerbated things and shouldn't have done. And then there was a $20,000 donation, which serves as a fine.
As a fine.
To a men's charity around behavioural awareness and the like. But the concession, when I saw what happened to Daniel, I acted on instincts. I now know that my instincts were wrong and that my actions could have led to a far more serious outcome. This is Shea Bolton. Daniel Rioli was cleared in what transpired. You've added the piece of information that on Friday, Bolton went into the AFL and met with Gil McLachlan.
Yeah, Gil McLachlan invited him in. We're going up on superfooty.com if it's not up,
it's up
already. Yeah, OK. Gillen, 48-year-old Gillen, called 22-year-old Shea Bolton in, spoke to him about what happened. There were sympathies, but explained to him why it was wrong. And the message clearly is, walk away from violence. Just walk away. So I'm not condoning violence, but I don't think everything is black and white in life like that, Jared. And you're not going to like this analogy, but I'm going to give you one. I'm out with you, three blokes start attacking you and punching you, and I walk away. Sorry, Jared, I've got to walk away from violence. That ain't going to happen, mate. It ain't going to happen. No one likes it. No one likes being put in situations where they have to act. So anyway, the AFL have come out and said to Shay, we need you, be a role model. We need you to come out and say, I should have walked away. The problem is no one listens to the AFL. When they're in pubs and clubs and they're fighting or at homes they're fighting, no one listens to the AFL. So they've whacked him with a $20,000 fine donation. $20,000. Fair dinkum. All the available evidence is not with us. The AFL nor Richmond will say anything about how he broke his hand. Have you got a reason, or do you think, have you got a reason why they're not sharing?
I think legally no one wants that on the public record for what the ramifications of that might be.
So let's just think worse.
That's the only way to interpret it as an opinion.
So there's only a couple of ways he could have broken his wrist. Fight's on, he's thrown a punch, he's broken his wrist. He threw a punch, hit him in the shoulder, broke his wrist. He fell over on his hand, broke his wrist. OK, so the AFL slapped him with $20,000 fine for sending a message, trying to send a message via Bolton to the rest of the public that to walk away from violence. 20,000 is far too much, mate. Far too much. He's a 22-year-old kid who's been told for 2 hours every weekend, I want you to be a competitor, I want you to support your mates, I want you to go out and play with such fierce determination. OK, I'll do that. 2 hours, thank you. And we clap them. We clap them. By the way, when an incident happens in a nightclub and your instinct, which we actually encourage you to have on the weekend, we need you not to have that instinct when you're a 22-year-old kid going through life thinking, what's going on? And they ping him and they use him to tell the world that violence is wrong.
Yeah.
To me, that's not right.
Yeah, I don't like that on-field, off-field analogy. I don't think that holds. That's just my view. And the $20,000 gives you a hint as to the severity
of the punch.
Of the act. That's how I would read that.
So, but how can we judge the severity if no one knows? Seriously, we're guessing with the $20,000.
Yeah, or you can extrapolate. And really, it's for the decision makers. It's for those in charge to make that decision, and then we can run our interpretations off that.
Shea Bolton, Jared?
Yes, that's it. That'll be our finishing point.
Yep. What do you want to know? Far away.
Do you think the $20,000 fine is the correct amount? Do you think the way it's been handled has been correct from the AFL? What's your answers to those questions?
I think those sort of incidents always need to be investigated so the truth can come out and you can find out what actually happened.
Do you know what happened?
Only from what I've been told, and that was what's happened. So
Daniel, no one knows what's happened.
Daniel and his partner found himself in the situation. Daniel was hit and Shay stepped in. I don't know what happened after that. The $20,000... it's pretty steep. 20 large is hurts anyone really, but it's finished now. Yeah, it's finished now. We've got an end to it, and we move forward.